हेलो फ्रेंड, दिस इज योर होस्ट सनी भाटिया। टुडे वी आर इन डे 7 ऑफ दिस ट्रेनिंग। टुडे वी विल बी स्टडीिंग मोर अबाउट ऑब्जेक्ट्स एंड कलेक्शंस फ्रॉम वेयर वी लेफ्ट। सो जस्ट लेट मी जस्ट रिव्यू व्हाट वी हैव डन अर्लियर। सो आई एम जस्ट रीस्टार्टिंग माय टैली। So what we did that day was we created our own objects and assigned it to the part, and we saw how the repeated collection has been done. So we should go ahead with objects and collections. This is all that we had covered that day. Now, what is the collection? Is collection acts as a bridge between the interface object and the data sources. Basically, a collection is a bridge between the your interface and data. So, the data sources can be internal tally object or any TDL object that we have created, like we have created a fixed object, or any external object too. So line is associated with the collection, and that's how the report is displayed. Now we come to part data retrieval during using methods. In a field using method prefixed by dollar, the context of a field is based on the data associated. Methods are always evaluated in current object concerns or by referring another data object. From the current object, it is dollar. By reference is dollar method name, object name, formula. Using index is dollar method name, collection, seek type, and direct assessing method is. These are the basically syntax. We'll cover them in detail in just a few moments. So dollar, like we have studied in the symbols and prefixes, the dollar is used to access the methods that are data objects in TDL. Now we come to the part what is the current context. Now before jumping into the current context and having the details of what the context means and how the things move on, let me create one report of ledgers, and then we see that how the things the context thing works. So let me move to TDL and see what we can do. So I'm opening my training program. So this was the day 6. Let us save it at day 7. And in the customization also of tally, I move it to day 7. So here I move it to day 7. So the same collection comes. Now let us first create my ledger report. So my first, I say tally report, and I'm going to change it my tally report. So I'm just quickly renaming the things. I hope that you are clear with the report part and field section. So I'm just hurrying up the things. And here the repeat part comes. Here I repeat as my tally line and my collection. And collection line, it is my tally line. And here I let us say as my or the sons of sun ledger name or sun. I name it as object name so that it's more generic. Right field right now I delete. Here I delete it. Now I come to the collection and here I remove these objects. And here I just say my collection is now type. When I say type, that means I am trying to use an internal collection which is predefined in tally, and as we saw that in schema we have ledger, and now I have tied it up with the, that means my collection is of type ledger. So all the ledgers that are there in tally, and in this case as a sample I have import some masters. As you see it has so many ledgers and so many stock items, stock groups. Just to give you the feel of live thing, I have imported it from a sample data. So let us see my, now you see I get the list of ledgers. Now the difference here you see is I have said dollar name, the name of the object, and what happens in tally is all the masters that are there, their basic name is always the name only. The method used for the masters is name. Let us say I have a group. So that means it's a ledger group. So I move to group, and group also has a method called name. Now right now my context here is ledger, since I have associated my collection and my collection is associated with the ledger of the internal TDL object. Now let me change it to group and see what happens. I am not changing anything in the report. I am just in the collection, I am changing it the context to from ledger to group, and let us see what happens. So you see I am now seeing the list of groups. That means the context is group now. So it is dollar name when I am, the name of the method is same, dollar name, but now instead of groups, ledgers, it is showing me. So let me change it to stock item. That means now my context is stock item. So now I am getting the list of stock items. So this is what the context means, that whenever I have a context, this is how the report works, that whatever is the context. So I again move it to ledger. Now let us design the report in a better way and understand some concepts of report designing. So I add another field. So I want to print a opening balance. Now for that method is So I am refreshing my report. Not getting open balance. There must be a problem in the spellings. So I go to my schema and see what is there in the opening balance. So opening balance. So I'm seeing the opening balance actually. So to put it in a right perspective, I change it to right field so that it comes on the right hand side. So now I'm getting the opening balance at the right hand side of the. Now let me format some of the fields. Now there are some standard templates that Tally has created. So this is a text field, and I know I say use name field. That means let us see what are the properties of the name field, but what, let me see the impact. And here I give it as use. Since it is an amount, I say use amount. So you see, under the bold. Now the blank has come because if it is zero, then it prints, the amount is printed as blank. So wherever the opening balances are there, something will be coming. No opening balances are there. So let me put one opening balances. I put it to fourth dimensional. Or put some opening balance to it. And you see the amount, I am seeing a formatting part as a special way. So this is a basic formatting of the report. Now we saw that the context, since I am using the method. So let me introduce one more. I want to print the group of the so the method for the group is parent. So I say parent. Again I say use name field set as. Now the method for the group in the ledger is parent. So let us say how it is acting. So now it is showing the group also. So I am having a closing balance, opening balance, name of the ledger. Now let me increase the width of the ledger so that it is a bit longer. Now you see it is better formatted. So I've just seen what is in my collection now. This is by default being sorted order in alphabetically. Automatically that the report is there is sorted on name at this point of time. Now we move further to the collections part. Now we come to the voucher object. Voucher object is a complex compound collection. It is having so many things. It is having sub collections also. A voucher collection has some methods as date, voucher type name, party ledger name, and similarly it has some inventory entries. It has ledger entries. these many things a voucher is having. So this is how the referring methods part is there. We'll study them in detail when we come here. And this is a method formula syntax, absolute relative. Study them in detail because right now if I start explaining it, the main part of the collection will be lost. So I am keeping this for a later section. Before moving to the voucher context, let us move to the rest or some other things of the PDL. Now let me define a title line to it. I am giving a Tally has one powerful feature. What I do is I say use my tail line. So the same part is there. Now I'll just explain how this works. I have a field called sun object name. So I say local sun. So I'm giving it a title. In my case, I'm giving it a ledger name since I know that it is ledger now. So instead of status, I move it to info. So I'm changing the balance mode. All of them are changed to info, and let us see what is the top of the same. So at the top I am seeing the title of the, let us give a border. So there is again, these are some the bottles up here. Now I want the sum of opening balances at the bottom. You think that will come? That means I want the total of opening balances at the last line. So I say here again, copy this entire thing. And here I say total, keep this as blank. And now I see how I can get the total. So right now I'm just saying it as amount 100. So that means the 100 will appear border at 2 times at the standard total. So let us see what happens now. So in the last I am getting the total as 100 as said, but now I want to have the totals of the opening balances. So we'll just see how we can get to it. The second section we'll see how we can get to the totals and some other aspects of the same. That's all for today.